For the last couple of years, I've been photographing and filming wildlife in my garden. And to do that, I've used a variety of different equipment and filming techniques. But the first and most important thing was attracting the wildlife. And if you've seen my previous two videos, you'll know that in that time, the biggest change that I have made to my garden was building a wildlife pond. It really is amazing just how much wildlife is attracted to something as simple as a large pool of water. So my first tip for anyone that's looking to attract more wildlife would be to have some form of water in your garden. Now, it doesn't have to be a big pond. It can be as simple as a bird bath or a really shallow small pond just tucked away somewhere in your garden. The main thing is that the water is present. Aside from providing animals with a fresh drink, it's also crucial for things like birds to bathe in, insects to lay their eggs in, and amphibians to grow up in. A garden pond can provide all of these and so much more, crucially providing a new habitat for encouraging wildlife. Which brings me on to tip number two, habitats. Now, increasing different habitats within your garden will dramatically increase the different variation of species that are attracted to your space. Providing different habitats within your garden will not only encourage species to breed, it'll help them thrive by providing plenty of shelter. Trees and hedges are a great way to do this, but obviously they take up much more space. So in smaller gardens, you can add things like brush piles or even just piles of rocks that will really help encourage the local insect population. And a healthy insect population in return will attract other species such as amphibians and birds. But you can give them shelter too by simply adding things like this frog house or even a couple of nest boxes, which now even have cameras so you can watch the wildlife visiting your garden from the comfort of your own home. But before we move on from insects too quickly, tip number three is adding plants. Adding a variety of native plants can be one of the best things for wildlife in your garden. Take these teasels for example. I started growing them because I wanted to attract more goldfinches, but it turns out that pollinators love the flowers created by this plant, but it doesn't stop there because aphids also love these plants. Now, to most people, aphids are a pest, but when it comes to wildlife, you have to remember that nature has a way of balancing itself. And with an introduction of prey, there also comes the predator. This is the larvae of a ladybird. And as you can see, this larvae is actively on the hunt for those aphids. But of course, different plants will attract different species, so a healthy mixture is always advisable. I try to go for different flowering plants that will flower at different times of the year and that will benefit a different variety of insect species, from moths to beetles to butterflies and various different pollinators. And when the flowers are done, don't forget that many birds will feed on the seed heads of various plants. Few other plants to bear in mind are fruit trees and fruit bushes. However, they do take up a lot more space, so bear that in mind when planting them. And my fourth tip is kind of a combination of the previous tips, and that is to provide food in your garden. Of course, bird feeders are the best example of this, but you may have to experiment with which type of foods work best for you. Personally, I've experimented with a few different types and had varying degrees of success in attracting different species. The most important thing to remember when doing this is to be consistent with the food, but also hygienic. Don't forget to clean your feeders if you are going to feed birds in your garden. I'll do a follow-up on this topic in the future, so stay tuned for that. But for right now, let's talk about actually recording the wildlife that does visit your garden. So at the start of this video, I showed how I record wildlife at my pond. And for that, I use my camera and lens. Now I am using a very old lens and I would love to upgrade this at some point in the future. But for right now, it's great and it shows that you don't need the best equipment to film wildlife in your garden. For me, the best quality images and video actually come from this camera setup that I'm using right here. But one of the things I really love to do is actually to record wildlife in my garden whilst I'm not even there. And there are a few different ways that I achieve this. So one of the cameras that I reviewed previously was this long range wireless camera, and that's great, but it does need a power supply. So another alternative would be to use something like these solar powered bird boxes, which I mentioned previously. And by the way, I'll have links to all of these in the description down below. But alternatively, my favorite way of recording wildlife is with using a trail camera. Now I've used a variety of different trail cameras over the years, and I have to say it's incredible how much the quality has improved over the years. Not only that, but also the features that they now include. So I was very excited when iZika sent me this new solar powered trail camera. This is the IG220. It has a 36 megapixel camera that records up to 2.7K at 30 frames per second with a no glow night vision. It also has a built-in rechargeable lithium battery that can be powered by the top mounted solar panel, and it has 4 AA battery slots that can be used as a kind of backup power source. Inside the box, it comes with a USB cable and tree strap, and you also get 12 month warranty, but an SD card and other batteries are not included. And although it doesn't film in 4K like some of the more expensive models, I was really impressed with the build quality, but also just the functionality and ease of use with this camera. And I think it has some really great features that I actually haven't seen in many other cameras like it. Whilst most trail cameras open with the camera on the door, this trail camera enables you to actually see what's in the shot while it's placed in the position that you want it to be in. A really great feature. And one other feature that I absolutely love are the light up buttons. I can't believe it, this is the first trail camera I've used with that feature. Such a great idea. But of course, the main feature of this trail camera is obviously the solar panel, and it worked really well. I had it set up here on this makeshift stand that I created, which I placed so that the trail camera can constantly watch over my pond. So this will not only help me save on batteries, but it'll also be a great addition in helping to film future updates on the pond series. Now, if you have any other tips or you think there's something I've missed, then please leave a comment down below. Let me and everybody else know so that we can all help in benefiting wildlife. And subscribe to stay tuned for future videos. See you then.